Perhaps it's time to discover why the Mazda CX-5 is still topping the charts for its class in 2023. What's this like? Let's go for a drive. I'm your host, Brian Max, racing driver, lover of driving fast, fun things. And on this channel, you get reviews for drivers from drivers. It's been a couple of years since we've driven the CX-5. And if memory serves, it's a pretty satisfying to drive crossover. But now there's been a lot of competition, and much of which we've driven and covered on this channel. So we have to have a look at this CX-5 in the context of 2023. Before we get into what it's like to drive, let's have a look at this CX-5 Signature in a little more depth. From a mechanical perspective, and the MX-5 is the exception, Mazda's crossovers and cars in this part of the world seem like a little bit of rinse and repeat in terms of their drivetrains. That's not necessarily a bad thing, because this is powered by the 2.5-liter turbocharged four-cylinder, makes 256 horsepower at 5,000 RPM, 320 pounds of torque at 2,000 RPM, and maybe a little bit less power and torque if you run it on cheap fuel. The transmission's a 6-speed automatic, no CVT, thankfully. This is all-wheel drive. Steering is electrically assisted, of course. Suspension's based around McPherson struts at the front, multi-link at the rear. Wheels and tires are 19s. Curb weight of this CX-5 with the turbo 4 and all-wheel drive is about 3,900 pounds. And given that this is the Signature model, I do have to mention this paint. This rhodium white metallic is a special paint. It's one of Mazda's specials that goes along with the Soul Crystal Red and the Machine Gray metallics, and this is very, very cool in person. Hopefully it's coming through on the camera. Did you know that about 80% of you are not subscribed? Yes, it's true. I checked the data and 80% of you are not subscribed. So if you enjoy the content on this channel, do me a solid, hit that subscribe button. While you're at it, be sure to like this video and share it. And if you don't mind, drop by our merch store. There's lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us, including our very popular line of Save the Manuals merch. Now back to your regularly scheduled episode. Behind the wheel, the CX-5, for a crossover anyway, is driver-centric perfection. The steering wheel is kind of the highlight, and there's one thing I have to mention about the steering wheel, and that is the heated function works in the zones where you're supposed to have your hands at 9 and 3. The rest of the seating position is exactly what you'd expect for a crossover. You're seated high, so you've got great visibility, but my relationship to the steering wheel, because there's a lot of adjustment in the steering column, is spot on, as well as my relationship to the pedals. Ergonomics are very much modern Mazda. They're very simple, straightforward, driver-oriented as well. There's not a lot here that's going to distract you, and I like the simplicity of this interior. The only thing I don't care for is the controller for the infotainment system. It's just a little awkward and clumsy, and especially since this screen is within reach of the driver, this would be perhaps better served as a touchscreen. Still, I use it on Apple CarPlay. It works perfectly for me. With respect to spaciousness, there's a ton of room in this CX-5. Here in the front row, you and your passenger are going to be very, very comfortable. And then in the second row, tons of room back there, at least for two normally sized adults and maybe a couple of kids. And under the hatch, there's lots of room as well. In terms of acceleration, yeah, it's relatively quick. Its 0 to 60 time is well under 7 seconds, probably 6.5. That's what it feels like anyway. Not sure what the official number is, but in terms of the real world, yes, it gets off the line quickly, and accelerating up to highway speeds is no trouble at all. The torque that this motor makes is absolutely spot on in the way it's calibrated to work with the 6-speed automatic. I've mentioned this before, but it's spot on as well. This drivetrain is just a wonderfully harmonized setup. It just works so perfectly together. No problem. This is quicker than most regular boring cars, so we can leave a stoplight in a hurry if we need. With respect to traction, yes, this is a part-time all-wheel drive system, but Mazda puts some extra care into the way that it's programmed. So you do have a sport mode, and then you've got an off-road mode as well, and that is something very unusual for sort of middle-of-the-road crossover. In this part of the market, CVTs are commonplace, and we don't really enjoy them. They're not that satisfying to drive. They are efficient, however, with their unlimited ratios. However, in an era where we've got 8, 9, and 10-speed transmissions, perhaps the 6-speed seems like an anachronism, but in reality, it's not. It is a wonderfully calibrated transmission, works perfectly with the 2.5-liter turbo 4, and with the abundance of torque that this engine makes, there's no need for anything more, but I like the way this transmission works. Funny thing is, even though this is still winter, I really didn't get to drive this in any snow. I'm kind of disappointed. I do like the way Mazda's all-wheel drive systems work in the snow. When you are behind the wheel, that's when this CX-5 really shines, because it's such a wonderful all-around driving experience. There's so many things going on here that aren't necessarily apparent. For example, the steering is wonderfully weighted. There's great heft to it, and the responsiveness is spot on. Similarly, Mazda does a great brake pedal. They pay attention to how the brake pedal feels for the driver, and I do generally enjoy Mazda's brake pedals. I've got millimeter control with this brake pedal. Feel is excellent, and power is excellent as well. In terms of handling, one thing that's not apparent is Mazda's GVC or G vectoring control, and it's something that I do subtly as a driver because I've been racing for so long, but it does that for you when you're behind the wheel. What it does is it results in more confidence when you're turning into a corner. It's a very, very cool system. Basically, what it does is when the car senses you're turning into a corner, it actually cuts engine output slightly to cause a little bit, a very indiscernible amount of weight transfer to that front axle. So the contact patches at the front of this CX-5 grow a little bit, and you've got better turn-in response. GVC is one of those very cool things that Mazda does. It's indiscernible, but it adds to your overall driving confidence and driving satisfaction when you're behind the wheel. In terms of handling, I have to highlight how well resolved the suspension is. But for starters, it's got McPherson struts at the front, multi-link at the rear, regular dampers, not even adaptive dampers here, and the damping on the CX-5 is perfect. Even though this is a crossover, and yes, the center of gravity is much higher than, say, a Mazda 3, for example, it's still very enjoyable to drive, and that's because as a dynamic package, it all comes together. The steering's responsiveness, the confidence you have in the brake pedal, and then the handling is all perfectly harmonized here, and that's really, I think, the objective that Mazda had in mind for the CX-5. It is very satisfying to drive. It is not lifeless and boring like so many crossovers that you can buy today. The way the steering wheel feels in your hand, then again, when you get on the brake pedal, this is a crossover that is really intended for drivers. If you don't want to drive a boring and dull, lifeless crossover, you need to check out a CX-5, and certainly if you don't believe me, drive this CX-5 back to back against any other crossover in the same segment, and you'll see exactly what I'm talking about. How do you spec yours? Well, the Signature only comes one way, which is finished in rhodium white metallic, and inside it's actually brown. In the US it's called Couture, and here in Canada it's called Coco. As tested, this is about $41,000 US or $44,000 Canadian. That's before freight and local taxes. And if you're gonna ask me, I still love the Soul Crystal red metallic paint, but this is actually pretty cool. One of the things I really like about the Signature is that it comes with silver wheels, not black wheels. I hate the black wheel trend anyway. As far as speccing your Mazda CX-5, I still think you need this drivetrain. You need the 2.5-liter turbo all-wheel drive that makes this CX-5 into an incredible performer, in addition to it being a capable crossover. Mm-hmm. My verdict, well, let's start with fuel consumption because some people are concerned about that. This, for me, was able to get 23 miles per gallon or about 10 liters per 100 kilometers, and that's in mixed driving, city and highway. And if you're easier on the throttle than I am, you'll see much better mileage. That said, there's no question in my mind, this is still tops for a mid-size crossover. And the reason is because it's satisfying to drive and it's very different from most of the other crossovers out there. This is engineered for drivers, it's built by drivers, and it's engineered and designed by drivers as well. Mazda just knows how to do that and it shines. You drive one of these compared to anything else in the category and you'll immediately notice a difference, and the CX-5 is absolutely designed, engineered, and built for drivers. Thanks for hanging out with me today and having a look at this 2023 Mazda CX-5 Signature. Hope you liked this episode, and if you did, well, you're not new to YouTube, you know what to do. Smash the subscribe button, turn on your notifications, like this video, and as always, sharing is caring. So please share this with your friends, especially on Reddit, because on Reddit, they really need to see reviews for drivers from drivers. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments below. I'll get back to you as soon as I can. If you want to support the channel, please hit up our merch store. Links here, links below. Lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us, including our very popular line of Save the Manuals merch, and Mazda still builds manuals. Thanks very much, Mazda. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you again next time. And remember, cars don't understeer by themselves, not even Mazda CX-5s.